A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 30th April, on the front page you have violence mars voting in Bengal, turnout up in fourth phase. So this is regarding elections, the voting which took place in the fourth phase in the following states and the number of seats for which elections took place and the percentage turnout. So it has been highest you can see in West Bengal, but it is also said that except for West Bengal, turnout remained below 70% in states and went to the polls as such in the fourth phase. And it is said that there was violence in West Bengal in some regions. So Election Commission has registered an FIR against BJP's Babul Supriyo for forcibly entering a booth. Then this is Election Commission ignored PM's hate speeches, Congress. So Supreme Court will take a petition on this today. So PM's hate speeches were ignored by the Election Commission when it put restraining orders on various leaders. Then below you have NIA arrests youth planning suicide attack in Kerala. So National Investigation Agency has been cracking down on in regions in Kerala in connection with the Easter blasts in Sri Lanka. So it has arrested a youth who was planning suicide attack in Kerala. And this is Cyclone Fani gathers force to hit Odisha. So Cyclone Fani, it has intensified into a severe cyclonic storm now and is headed towards Odisha coast. So this is what the Indian Meteorological Department has said. It could become an extremely severe cyclone by Wednesday too. On page 3 you have NGT directs UP government to take remedial action. So this is National Green Tribunal which has directed the Uttar Pradesh government to take steps in curbing water pollution around industrial areas in the state. So there have been a report published by UP Pollution Control Board stating that industrial effluents are contaminating the Hindon River in UP. So now NGT is asking UP government to take action. Then on page 5 you have High Court adjourns plea challenging NGT order on sand mining. So this is a petition filed by the owner of a construction and sand mining company in Andhra Pradesh High Court. So it's against the NGT order on sand mining in the state. So NGT, you should know, it had asked Andhra Pradesh government to deposit 100 crore for the damages done by unregulated sand mining in the state. And it has banned mechanized sand mining in Andhra Pradesh. So on this, the tribunal order, the owner of a construction and sand mining company has moved High Court. So it talks of huge losses because of this order. Then on page 7 you have German bakery blast, charges framed against Yasin Bhatkal. So this is Indian Mujahideen co-founder who was arrested in 2013 in the German bakery blast case. This is the blast which took place in Pune, in Pune's popular German bakery in Koregaon Park area in 2010. So 17 people died and more than 50 were injured. So presently he pleads not guilty and rejects the charges. Then below you have Army invokes emergency powers for missile deal. So Army is set to procure two systems from Israel and Russia. So it is in the process of procuring this Spike LR anti-tank missiles from Israel and Igla S very short range air defense systems from Russia. So these will be done through new set of financial powers for emergency procurements sanctioned by the Defense Ministry earlier in the month. Then below you have committee constituted to oversee clean air program. So the Union Environment Ministry has constituted a committee to implement the National Clean Air Program NCAP, which aims to reduce particulate matter pollution by 20 to 30% in at least 102 cities by 2024. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the heat moves north. So this says that the BJP has more to lose than gain in the fourth phase of the Lok Sabha elections. So there are 72 constituencies across 9 states where elections are being held. So BJP had won 45 of these 71 seats in the 16th Lok Sabha and its allies had won 11. Then this is Biden's bid. So this is regarding former Vice President of USA Joseph Biden. He has finally announced his candidacy for the 2020 US presidential elections. So the editorial says Bidan might be the strongest democratic candidate, but he's not necessarily the best. Then the lead article, no good options in Afghanistan. So this talks of how in Afghanistan reconciliation means different things to different players and to different groups of Afghans too. So how peace would come forth is, you know, the viewpoints are different. And then this is line of confidence. So this is regarding how cross LOC trade has been suspended. So and demands been made to permanently stop it too, which we have seen. So streamlining business across LOC will require both infrastructural and policy level interventions is what this article is arguing. Then on OPED page, important article is for a malnutrition free India. So this talks of effective monitoring and implementation of programs so that country achieves its goal of overcoming malnutrition by 2022. And this is an insidious poll trend. It says the cash for votes practice is no longer limited to the South. It's time to think of ways to restore democracy. So, you know, the election commission has confiscated cash, gold, silver, liquor, drugs, and other items across the country in these general elections. On page 10, you have respond to plea on EVMs and VVPATs. Supreme Court tells Election Commission. So Supreme Court has sought a response from the Election Commission on a plea to decriminalize the act of reporting deviant behavior manifested in EVMs and VVPAT system during elections. So there is this Rule 49 MA of the Conduct of Election Rules 1961. So it criminalizes reporting of malfunctioning of EVMs and VVPATs. So if your complaint turns out to be frivolous, then you would be punished. The voter or the person who's complaining would be punished. So on this, a petition has been filed in the Supreme Court, and Supreme Court is asking Election Commission to respond. Then on international page here, you have Socialist Party wins Spanish election. So this is regarding elections in Spain. So apart from this is also not very important. So that's the news. On business page, you have liquidity crisis hits Reliance Capital Arms firms. So home, commercial finance, arms witness minor delay in principal repayment of 542 crore and 477 crores. So these are Anil Ambani's NBFCs, non-banking finance companies. So they are facing a liquidity crunch here. Then below you have India-China team on pharma to meet next month. So India and China are sending the high level, India is actually sending its high level delegation to the first meeting of the working group on pharmaceuticals with China, which is scheduled in Beijing in May 2019. So this is an initiative under the India-China Strategic Economic Dialogue Mechanism. The working group will meet and it will bring out efforts. So how India is growing its efforts by in increasing pharma exports to China. Then on the last page, you have genes of climate resistant chickpea varieties identified. So this is ICRISAT, International Crop Research Institute for Semi-Arid Tropics. So it has identified in chickpea there are 4 important genes for heat tolerance and 3 important genes for drought tolerance. So identification of these genes, important factors for heat and drought tolerance, will be able to develop chickpea variety which can be climate resistant. Then this is, so ICRISAT, you should know, it's Hyderabad based firm. It was an international team led by it which has made this discovery. Then this is lawyer fighting palm oil industry wins ecology prize. So this is Alfred Brownell. So he has won the Goldman Environmental Prize for exposing alleged abuse by palm oil companies, in Liberia. So around 50 kilometer square forest, was converted, was prevented from being converted into the palm oil plantation as such. So there are elephants and other animals which live in these forests which would have been affected too. So he, along with 5 other activists, have been honored by this Goldman Environment Prize. Then below you have drug resistant diseases could kill 10 million in a year by 2050. So this is UN report which calls for prudent use of antibiotics, because if antibiotics are misused, are not taken in proper doses at proper intervals, then drug resistance develops, which could result in the antibiotics turning ineffective in future. So this is what the UN report is highlighting, that it could kill, such cases could kill 10 million a year by 2050. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. So current affairs as a PDF also is uploaded there by the end of the day. Yesterday's news will be uploaded shortly. So it was a day off because of elections. So that is it. Thank you.